Zito talked about was Kevin Stedlin. He said it's hard to find 6'5" right-handed centerman. 2-on-1, peak right circle, shoots wide. Far side, one of the Bruins got buried behind the play. And it's going to be A.J. Greer dropping the gloves for the second time against the Bruins. And I think he's with Zacha. Pastrnak is down. He and Boqvist are slow to get up.
Well, you got to love Zacha standing there. This is not his game, but his teammate got ran from behind a little bit, didn't like it. Greer obviously a lot more accustomed to dropping the gloves, but Zacha stands up for his teammate. That goes a long way on that Bruin bench and within the locker room.
Boston, number 18, Florida, number 10. Both players, five-man majors fighting.
Now, there's the hit by Greer. We've seen that called many times for a penalty from behind a little bit on the numbers. Both referees got a good look at it, decided it was not a penalty. They didn't feel it was on the numbers enough. Got to disagree.
And it looked like after Greer registered the hit brick, that it put him in an awkward position, colliding with Jesper Boqvist.
Yeah, it's a dangerous play on a star player in this league. I don't know how that's not a penalty on a hit from behind. That close to the boards on a player that can't protect himself. Where's the penalty?
Jim Montgomery getting an explanation from the senior referee, Dan O'Rourke. A.J. Greer, a couple years ago, when he played his first full season in the National Hockey League with the Bruins, finished among the league leaders in penalty minutes. Last year, after getting picked up on waivers, he spent the entire year in Calgary.
Judd, tell me, why not call the penalty and then go take a look at it? If you got it wrong, you reduce it, rescind it. I mean, that's